Hey, what's kicking, Gooder Gang? Rob from the So Smoking Gooder Show. Guys, I'm at a cook-off, and I'm going to take you behind the scenes. I'm in Garrison, Texas. Where's that? That's in East Texas, just north of Nacogdoches. So I'm up here for a CBA contest, a Champions Barbecue Alliance contest. I'm going to take you behind the scenes of my Friday night. I don't know about much prepping because I already did all that. But maybe just some shenanigans from Friday night. And then tomorrow, Saturday, is the cook-off. So this video is going to be all about that. Y'all come check it out. We'll see you in a minute. All right, gang, we're back. It's 8:05 on Friday night. I still have some prep to do. Basically do some brines and injections. They're already mixed and pre-made. I did those earlier today. I already did all my trimmings today. Maybe I'll show you that here in a minute. I don't know yet, but I'll figure it out. But I was gonna give you a little tour of Bullhorn One. This is my competition trailer. It is a 8.5 by 16 foot trailer. Tour the inside. I'm very stoked. That loud noise you hear is from this guy. Thank you to Rick's RV Rentals and Repairs for giving me a great deal on this Coleman 1500 BTU air conditioning. It's the first time that I've had AC in Bullhorn One, as I like to call her. Bullhorn One, absolutely. That's where we are. So this thing is blowing cold, it's loud, and I love it. Another addition that I had, peep my Team Cosmo cup. This guy, I didn't know I needed it until I saw it this week, but this is a made by General. You can find it at Northern Tool. I just happened to stumble in looking for something completely random and saw this, and I'm glad I did. It lifts up. Oh, it's got all my goodies in there. Don't look at that. Don't look at that. But it also got some, it holds my knives. Little trinkets. It's got all my goodies in here. Where are we at over here? Just some stuff. Just stuff that I need on the daily at a cook-off. But you can find that sucker for $239 at Northern Tool, and I'm damn stoked to have it. I've got my AC unit. What am I talking about? My refrigerator, as most people like to call them. But you can see I've got my my comp mates are all trimmed and ready to go. Normally, if I would have done them on Wednesday, I would have vacuum sealed them. But because I just did them earlier, probably about 5 hours ago, they're okay in there. And I got some stuff, other stuff in there. So anyway, that's the tour of Bullhorn. I got my speaker, I got two prep tables, one here and one back there, as you can see. So, that's the inside tour of Bullhorn One. Hope you liked it. Let's go check out the outside. This wrap was done by Bull Printing Wraps and Graphics, the best in the, look at this guy. Cruz in the house.
Yeah, like the party.
Like the, what do you like? What do you like?
Party.
There's the other gang over there, the Holy Smoke Gang, and there's my son Eli. They're all having fun at a cook-off. But this right here was done by Bull Printing Wraps and Graphics, the best in the business. If you guys need any wraps or signs, banners, any of that, he's the man. Cheeto Mesquise over at Bull Printing Wraps and Graphics. This thing was wrapped. This is probably 2015, but this guy was 2012 and still looks amazing. Check that out. Still looks amazing. Hope I can like flip this and edit. I don't know. If you can't, I'll put him in the comments. Look at me talking like a YouTuber. I'm not a YouTuber. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. What do you guys think? And back here, got some sponsors from a couple years back. Eureka Heights, Rec Tech. It's a new logo now, but there they are, right here. Bull Printing, Wraps and Graphics. Best in the biz. I got my Rec Techs out here. I got the Bullseye and the Bull. And I got me some Gateway Drum Smokers. These are the guys that are going to go do some work this weekend. So, anyway, that's the setup here. Cruz, you want to say something? Say hi to the peach, man.
I'm the rock man.
You're the what?
The Andre the Giant.
Nice. Nice. You're a wrestling fan?
Yeah.
All right. All right, guys. So, we'll come back. I'm going to go visit some teams, and I'll bring you along with me. How's that? All right, we're back. We're back. Friday night shenanigans, about 8:10. I'm here with Timmy Esch and Miss Anna Brown Price.
Put me on video. I have no makeup on.
Hi, oh my gosh! No,
hit the filter button.
Yeah, filter. It's all right. We'll do it in edit. Don't worry about it. Tim, 8:10. I'm trying to get a little back behind the scenes action at a cook-off. Okay. What are we doing right now? It's 8 o'clock.
Got everything prepped. Generator quit today. Had to replace the fuel pump or fuel filter. So we're back in action. We got air conditioning, and we're hanging out.
We're doing it at 8:10, going to make a drink.
Make a drink over there.
We're having our non-alcoholic drink.
Yeah, we can't have alcohol here.
Alcohol
wink, 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 yeah. Wink, wink, wink. Can't even do it. So you just mentioned everything's prepped, like you're rubbed and everything, or you're trimmed and everything.
So no, I trim before I come here. So this is my first CBA. Mm-hmm. So I look at this as a combination of KCBS versus and IBCA mixed. So what I'm looking at is KCBS presentation with IBCA texture.
That's smart. That's smart, people.
So that's what I'm hoping for. First one, we'll see how it works.
So you're going to the Royal?
I'm not going this year.
You're not going this year.
No, no.
But you've done plenty of Royals.
I've done one. Yeah.
One?
That one you were at.
Oh, that was it?
Yeah. Won't bring that up.
We won't talk about that one. No. No. But, so do you feel there's a lot of Texas teams going up this year?
Yeah, I'd like to go. I'll go next year.
Do you feel like the CBA is going to help them?
I think so, yeah. When I went there, I had only done one or two KCBS, and it was all I could do to get everything turned in, but now I think their CBA will help everybody, except for the chicken. Chicken's a little different.
Chicken is way different. I'm actually doing legs. I've always done thighs, but I'm going to do legs this year.
What I do is I recommend you wait till you get there and try them the day of the contest. Don't prep them at home. Don't ever experiment with anything. Just show up to a contest and do it that day of.
There you go.
Did you take my
there
sarcasm?
You go. Oh. Was that what it was?
You detected my sarcasm?
Yeah. I did not. Yeah. Maybe they did. I hope y'all did. I did not. Well, cool. Well, that's Tim Esch from Tiny E Barbecue or Smoker. Okay.
Yep.
Tiny E Barbecue. Where are you located at?
Allen, Texas.
Allen, Texas. Where exactly is that?
North of Dallas.
North of Dallas. All right. There you go. We still claim him, even though he's north of Dallas.
Yeah. Well, I come down and cook with you guys a lot. I'm not scared to go out of that local area. So.
Absolutely. All right, cool. So we'll visit a little bit more here in a little bit. Y'all stick around. All right, guys, I'm back, and I am here with, y'all may probably know this guy, Robert Smith, First Class Barbecue. He's been all over Barbecue Pitmasters. He's been on, Smoked?
Smoked.
Smoked. What else you been on?
Everything.
Everything.
Everything. Smoked, Pitmasters.
He had that Shell Rotella truck and all that big
Hey, it's
pit.
Coming back.
It's coming back. And he's giving us a treat, guys. He's going to let us see... How, oh my God, I can't turn this thing around. Are you serious?
Oh.
Are you serious, video?
Yeah. So if you guys notice, I season my brisket in a bag.
You season it
in
a
bag. I inject my brisket in a bag.
You inject it in a bag. Pro tip. And he's going to let us check out him seasoning this thing. So I'm not going to keep flipping this around. When he gets going, I'm just going to let him talk and let y'all watch. This is a... Did not expect this, but this is really cool. He's volunteered to do this for us, so y'all check this out. This is going to be good. Oh, and we got light now.
We got light.
We are in the first-class barbecue rig.
In the trailer.
We're in the trailer. All right, let's go. Here we go.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and clean up all that injection. We're going to try and get it as dry as possible. Hey, if you've ever just used those aluminum pans, just break down and buy you a good one right here. Wash it. It's going to save you a lot of money. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean off all of that extra injection. So what I do is I get here on site as soon as possible. And believe it or not, this is actually a choice brisket that I got from Walmart.
Wow.
It was, you know, coming up here, I knew there was only going to be a certain amount of teams. And I knew the payout. So I didn't want to spend the money and buy a Wagyu.
That's a good point. you just know, you know, you got other battles to do.
Exactly. Right? Yeah, exactly. So. So just, you know, take it in stride. Every cook-off didn't have to be $1,000.
So if y'all notice, he did pat this thing completely dry. And Rob, if y'all don't know, is the number one cooker in CBA right now. We're all chasing him.
He took that from me.
Yeah. And that was hard. That was hard. You're a bad dude. All
right. Nice.
So we've got that thing wiped down clean. So now what we do, and of course, you know, I do travel with the kiddos and the girls, so we got to stumble around all their stuff. So they make beds and all that kind of crazy stuff. And of course, you got to come out with the duck fat.
That's why we're not live. We're doing this to YouTube.
All right, so I do run my own seasonings. So this is a Perfect Storm. Perfect Storm is going to start hitting the market probably in the next week or so. We've been working on this rub for probably about a year because I'm not gonna use it unless it's good.
He gave me a sample of it, and about 4 minutes ago now, it's really good.
It's good. It's got a good
lingering.
It's really savory flavor.
Yeah, yeah.
So we use it as a base. So I'm going to go one. And two. That's it. So now, actually, this is our...
Tell me about these rubs. I know there's something different about the names of the rubs, right?
Yeah. So if a lot of people know me, so I used to rodeo. I used to fight bulls. I used to ride bulls. And so all of my rubs are named after famous bulls. I mean, Promised Land, Perfect Storm. It's just something that I take with me. I can't fight bulls anymore because I'm, you know.
You'd probably whoop their ass now. Just saying.
I could probably wrestle with them. So our next rub is going to be Promised Land, which is, of course, our rubs. And this one here is just a light coat. We're just going to go one pass. That's it. So that one there has got a lot of cumin, it's got a lot of red peppers, it's got a lot of little spice to it. And then last but not least is our buddy old Tim Shear from Blue Sog. And this in here has got lots and lots of beef flavor to it. It's really, really powerful.
It's the Bold and Beefy?
It's the Bold and Beefy. So
that is a really good tasty rub.
Oh, it does. And so I kinda go a little bit heavy on it. I'll go sideways, up and down, every which way.
You do the same process on the front side?
No.
Nope.
So on the front side, we're going to do something a little different. So we're going to go ahead and just pat it. I don't rub it. I don't try and push the rub off. I don't try and do any of that.
It's called a rub, but nobody rub now. We don't rub it.
We don't rub it at all. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and flip it over. Everything's set. So now if you see... Everything is really nice and clean.
That is just a nice choice, guys.
That's just a choice.
If you believe them.
That's just a choice. And seeing what we did is I went and I told a lot of guys, I trimmed my meat. I came down early. So this is in Garrison. Mm-hmm. So I came down early and stayed with Anna and Scotty. And we trimmed our meat yesterday. And I said, look, Scotty. I said, look what I'm cooking. He said, there's no way. And I said, yeah, this is what I'm cooking. And he verified it right there.
Nice.
This is a $45 brisket from Walmart.
Nice. I'll show y'all mine later. I'm cooking a prime from Costco, which I love too. I thought,
exactly. Dude, phenomenal.
It looks great, by the way.
Exactly.
It looks great.
So what this is, in this little shaker, I'll go ahead and grab it. Another pro tip. Take it.
Hey, tender quick.
Tender quick.
TQ.
It's a little chemical that we use. We cook on drums, so we don't get a lot of smoke. There's not a lot of smoke at all. So a lot of your judges, they have that thing in the back of their head. They're like, we need to see a smoke ring.
Smoke ring.
We gotta see a smoke ring. This will give you a smoke ring. Mm-hmm. So, and
are you doing? While you're doing on cans, are you putting any wood chunks or anything like that in there?
Yeah. So hey, you know what I use?
Apple?
No.
Pellets?
No.
What?
Mesquite.
Mesquite.
We're in East Texas. So I've run pecan, I've run hickory, I've run everything. And the yellow thing. And come to find out that the mesquite gives off a lot of smoke. And it's
look at her.
What?
Johnny on the spot.
There you go.
And this girl right here is a really good competition cook in the Kids Q circuit. You'll be hearing her name quite a bit down the road.
All right, so what we're going to do here, we don't want to go super heavy with this because we're not going to wash it off. We're going to let it run. So we're going to start down here. I start at the end of my deal, so it's not hitting the brisket. So I'm seeing a little bit of color, so now I'm just going to run.
And that's it.
And that's it.
Yeah, barely on there.
So
a lot of people wash that off after a few minutes, but they go a lot heavier than that.
They'll wash it off and everything like that. So I'm gonna let that set for, it's 8:23. I let that set for 15 minutes, and I repeat the same process that I did on the bottom, on the top.
Cool.
And that's just
15 minutes on that light coat, and he's gonna wash it off. And then we go. Hey man, thank you so much, brother. Look at guys, y'all. I had no idea we were getting all of that, but consider yourselves lucky right here. This guy is one of the top cookers in all the country right now. He's focusing on some CBA, which is fun. We're having a good time in this new barbecue circuit. But anyway, that was fun. We're gonna go see if we can catch some more people. Appreciate y'all checking it out. All right, gang, we're back in Bullhorn One, and it's 9:06, and I am, we're getting our injections ready, and our brines. There's my lovely assistant right there. Say hello.
Hello.
She's getting the brines. Oh, y'all saw Robert Smith's brisket earlier, and I said I had a prime. Y'all check this prime out. It's looking pretty nice for a prime. I'm cool with that. And here's my pork butts. These are Prairie Fresh pork butts. There they go. Only doing two this one. I normally cook three. But my third one had a funky smell, so I said, not today, not today. So that's what we're doing. Again, 9:07. Would like to do it a little early. I didn't get here until late. I got here around about 7 o'clock today. So kind of running behind the gun, but not really. I feel as long as we get them done by 10 o'clock, we're fine. We'll be in good shape for what I got to do tomorrow. So anyway, we'll come back on a little later. Y'all keep sticking around. Appreciate y'all watching. All right, checking in. We are done with prep. And it is 10:52, done with prep. Everything's ready to go in the morning. I'll be waking up about 5 a.m. to get started. So I'll be going to bed hopefully soon. We'll see. I'm gonna go see who's still up. We'll see what's up. But yeah, I'm ready. Ready for tomorrow. All my meats are ready. They are either brining or injected, except for chicken. I'll do that a little later. But that's it. We're all ready to go for tomorrow. We'll see how it goes. Wish us luck. All right. Good morning, Gooder Gang. That's what I'm going to call y'all by from now on. So get used to it. All right, it is Saturday morning. It is 8:06. I've got my brisket on. I've got my pork butts on. I've got my second pit coming up to temp, because I got ribs going on at 8:30. Y'all check out these ribs. Nice. That'll do. That'll do. That'll do. I've got chicken. They're not rubbed. They are, they're in the process of getting the process. But, yeah, so day two, looking good so far. I feel good. Woke up on time, 5 a.m. So I've been at it for 3 hours now, and we'll see how it goes. I'm thinking about doing the old Bill Purvis. Shout out to Bill Purvis, my boy from Chicken Fried Barbecue. Thinking about doing, I'm going to do one and one on these chicken halves. I'm going to do a Tiger Stripe a la Bill Purvis. And I'm also going to do a, just the ones that I've been doing. I'm number one in CBA right now, chicken, so I don't want to change too much. Just kind of want to do it for appearance. We'll see. We'll see what happens. But, so I got the Rectech smokers here. The Bullseye is getting hot so that I can do one of those as a Tiger Stripe. And I've got these gateways going. Come on. Well, that didn't go very well for y'all, but they look good. How y'all like my little my little patio curtains? They're doing the job, because this guy is doing his job. And so, anyway, I'll come back a little later. So thanks for sticking in. If you're still watching this, you are a hero. I appreciate you. We'll talk to you soon. All right, it's 10:38. It's about 20 minutes till turn in. And I did a big fail, boys and girls. I went and tried something at a cook-off, and that's a no-no. You don't do that. You don't try new things at a cook-off, but here we are. 20 minutes to turn in, and I told you earlier I was going to go for that Bill Purvis Tiger Stripe. Well, I did it, but I really didn't. Look at that. That is not pretty. Although, I'd eat the crap out of it, but for turn-in, I don't know. Not happy! But we may have something to say about that. We'll see. Okay, alright, so Tiger Stripe didn't work out so hot, but we're going with the old trusty chicken. A little Bullhorn chicken action. That's the guy I'm going with. Not that guy. That guy. Still a little dark, but I kind of like it. We'll see what happens. Let you know later. There's the chicken box, guys. I got it. One done. Two done. All right, guys, these are some good looking ribs. Except for that one that just fell over. It's okay. You're an end guy. You're basically protecting my middles. And this guy has a funky, broken, he's got a broken bone. So I'm gonna put him on the end too, just to protect these guys in the middle. All right, let's go to the pit. All right, so we pulled the ribs off the pit, and I've got 3 minutes to box and get the heck out of here. Again, I didn't like these two ends, so I am pulling them. Cut this guy off to show some bone. All right, there we go. 6, 7. Okay, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go 6, I guess. Not the prettiest, but I've won it like this before. So I am just gonna go 6 in the box, and I'll throw a 7th up here for good measure. All right, baby, I need a towel quickly. Clean the back of the box. Get your photo. I'm gonna be walking in 1 minute. Here. I don't know. You have one job. Just kidding. I'm teasing her. I'm just teasing her. Get up higher. There you go. Okay, let's box her up and let's go. How they look, Diane?
Look beautiful.
All right. So we are at 1.5 minutes to go, and I probably have a 30-second walk. We got it. Look, they're calling us.
Don't laugh. Why? Why did you wait till the last minute, Rob? Why?
Y'all act like you don't know me.
No joke, always.
Look at it. I ain't lag. Go ahead. Go ahead. Look, film that clock. All right, let's go.
Kevin.
Hold on, Eli, we got 30 seconds. Let's see some running. Mr. Kevin should be running up any moment. Here he comes, flip-flops and all. Where's he at? I don't, you see him? There he is, flip-flops and all.
No, 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 no.
Oh, flip flop, no.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
All right, guys, we are about 12:17. Show them the clock, Eli. 12:17. All right, come on. And we've done chicken, and we've done ribs, and now we're about to start the pork process. So I have my money muscles here. I normally cook 3, but today I am doing just 2 pork butts. So I'm gonna put this back behind you. So I'm going to attempt to get the bacon, and if you guys don't know where the bacon is, I will show you. These are my pork butts minus the money muscle, and the bacon is right behind this fat cap, and hopefully, if all goes well, Diane, you got that strainer ready? We're gonna strain this rib au jus for some, or pork au jus. For some goodness. Hey baby, come hold this so I don't spill it. Much better. try to keep it sealed, babe. And so that's a fat separator. Okay, so if all goes well, I should be able to pull this and expose the bacon. I need a sharp knife. Okay, so there's the bacon. Eli, you can come by here. See the top of it right here? This is what we're after right here. And it's underneath all this fat. It's underneath all this fat right here. So I'm gonna get a knife. All right, so I'm gonna still try and go with my fingers. If you cook it well, and it looks like we may have today, should just come right, this fat should just come right off and expose this beautiful, tasty bacon. And this is what we're after, boys and girls. All right, we did okay. Now the only thing we got to worry about is texture and make sure that it's texturally tasty. You don't want to get it, this has a tendency of you overcook to get mushy. See that? The fat's just coming right off. And there's the bacon. It's not technically bacon. Bacon's from the pork belly. This is a pork shoulder, but it's what we call the bacon of the pork shoulder. All right, so we have that. I'm gonna put it in this pan over here because we are going to we can still clean this up just a little bit, but that is what we're after. And I can tell, yeah, I just took a bite. It's not overly mushy, but generally I'm gonna try and stick with just bacon and money muscle. All right, we're sitting at 1224, so I still want to
turn it at 1250.
Yeah, turning is at 1250. So let's see if I can.
So I've got a lot of.
See if I can get this guy. Boom, fat cap gone, bacon. Ooh, this one is even in much better shape. Much better shape, guys. But that's what you want. So when you're searching in the store for pork, a lot of them have this exposed. The fat cap is exposed. You want to try and find them where it hasn't been, you know, the butcher hasn't trimmed off the fat cap. Because this is what you're after. Yeah, this thing is just coming right off. See that? There's a tube right there. You see that? That's what they call a tube. I'm going to pull that out of there too, and we'll see how that goes. But at this point, just take your knife and gently, I'm not putting any pressure downward. I'm just pulling it back. Oh, man. I'm glad we're filming this today because it doesn't always work out this way. I will tell you that. And look at that. That is just clean. See the difference between this one?
Number two and number one.
And that one? This is still good. But I can just tell already. So I'm going to kind of keep them in two different piles. And let's go get our rib au jus, our pork au jus. We just want that pure goodness. Just cover these up, let them soak that in. And that's what we want for that. I'm gonna put that over there. And I am just going to take this piece of foil and throw this on here. If I want to come back to it, I will. Again, I talked about the tube. I'll throw that in here too. A lot of people like these.
I'll only use it if I'm not happy with my other cuts of pork. But that's it right there. There's your tube. So I'm gonna throw that also in the au jus. And that's it. Now this is tasty.
Up here.
This is really good. It's really good eating, but for a competition box, not a big fan. So guys, when you're doing pork, to me, it's the most time-consuming turn-in. Chicken, just kind of pull them off, put them in the box. Brisket, slice them up. Rib, slice them up, put them in the box. Pork, you got to search for what you want. You got to look around, search for what you're doing. All right, now, the money muscles. They've been soaking in the same
pork au jus,
yep. There's a nice round guy here. That's money muscle number one. No, leave the, we're gonna keep that.
Over there?
Oh, yeah.
Getting it out of the way.
Oh, I see what you're doing. Well, let's go with Mooney muscle number two, a little smaller guy. Still will play. So, I took these to about 204. There's no real right or wrong answer. The more you go any higher than that, you run the risk of a mushy guy. Let's go put these on the pit because I want these to get hot again. Just gonna let them soak that up. All right. So we're gonna take our pork sauce. Just kind of run it all over it. You can dunk these too if you want. The pork au jus for the money muscles will play into the slicing. For now, I'm just gonna sauce these up. It's not Smoky Mountain. I just love these pour bottles. Yeah, they make it so much easier. I got some Cosmos Cherry Hab, which is
19 minutes.
Which is a thank you. My son just told me 19 minutes, which is awesome. Which is a game changer for pork. It's got a little, it's got some Blues Hog as well, but the Cherry Hab on pork just works. All right. Let's see what these look like in the sunlight here. Those are looking pretty. And we'll slice them up and make them look really good. Let's get this fat off of here. We don't need these guys anymore. All right, let's put these on the pit. You open that pit, bub? You don't gotta open all of them. All right, we're just gonna let that sauce set. I might hit it again in a minute. And then we'll come back for the boxing. right, boys and girls, we're back. Hope you guys like that pork video. See how we do. I really did like what we turned in. Thought it was all good. Well, we're going to go with the big bad boy, the brisket. And for the sauce, we're keeping it simple. We're keeping it Texas. We're going with some Aaron Leslie's Texas Oil Dust Brandon Oil. This is a great, just a smooth, thin sauce. As you'll see when I put it in, you have to hit it a couple times. It's got some sugar, some garlic. It's ketchup based. So one thing I just took away from this is the garlic, and I love me some garlic. So I enjoyed the sauce, so I use it. How about some Bon Jovi for it? I do not own the rights to this music, nor did I sing that song, but here we go. All right, Union been on strike. He's down on his luck. You know the song. All right. I can smell the garlic. I love it. Come over, check it out. Real thin. You can see it in the bottles. Real thin. And I'm just gonna pour it over and let it gravity do its thing. This bottle died a hero. Hopefully. All right, again, let gravity do its thing. Come back up here with this fresh bottle from Aaron Leslie. It smells delicious. Delicious. All right, so we're gonna take this and we're gonna go put it back on the Rectech bowl. That's how we like to do things over here. We're living that Rectech lifestyle. If you don't know about Rectech, you should know. The best pellet smoker on the market. All right, let me get that lid, Bubba. I'm dripping. Hurry. So we're just putting it on here to let that sauce set. And we're gonna close her up. And we'll come back.
In a second.
Yep, we'll come back. All right, guys, we are 140, 20 minutes to turn in. I'm going to pull the brisket. 10 minutes till the window opens. 20 until end all, be all. Look at that. She looking pretty. She looking fat though. Let's see what we gotta do about that in a box. I'm gonna get that au jus. Turn the grill off. Got some tasty aj. It's been in the grill along with
brisket for about 20 minutes.
Along with brisket. Let's spin this around so I can slice her.
With the grain.
Y'all can see the grain is this way?
Grain going straight like this.
So which way we got to slice, do you know?
Against the grain, so we're going like
this. Yeah, very good, Eli.
That's it. Done. That's it's all right. Over but the crying.
That's right.
All right, guys. We're outside of Garrison in Brassville. Or what? What was it?
Bryceville.
Yeah. Bryce. She's saying Bryce, not Brass. We're here. We're out here. We're done with the cook-off. What's up, guys? Here we go. We're done with it. We're going to do this.
No, we're not.
So thank y'all for watching that video we did today. And so we're going to do some of this to celebrate. And we'll do that here in just a second. But first off is the fireball shots. All right.
You have it.
I got it.
Here's to y'all, here's to me. Best friends, we will always be. And May, I can't say it on TV. Titties and belly buttons never meet!
What? Cheers!
Woohoo! Hey! Yeah,
you know,
it's so delicious.
Are we supposed to drink all of them?
Yeah.
What
was that question?
Are we supposed to drink all of it?
I don't know if that was a good idea, but we did it. We did it. All right. So where's he at? All right, he walked over there. So we'll get him in a minute. But man, that was fun. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. Yes, it's late. We've been drinking. That's what happens at a cook-off.
Rob, do we drink at a cook-off?
A lot.
A lot.
Nobody's got. Hey, congratulations
thank
on your
you
day
so
today.
Much. Fun. Thank you.
And where are we at right now? What are we doing right now?
We're having a little after party. We're fixing to eat some chicken tacos.
Nice.
And we're at our family's house, Pokey and Carolyn. And we're cooking all kinds of shrimp kisses and carne asada, and all kinds of good stuff.
Awesome.
Kids are swimming, so that's what it's all about. It's barbecue family is what it's about.
Well, thank you, sweetheart.
Thank you.
Congratulations on your day. That was awesome. All right, well, there she was. Anna Brown.
Bryce.
And Scotty Bryce.
And that's Scotty Too Hottie.
Kicking ass today.
They can't clone me.
Kicking ass today. Yeah, we're celebrating today. We all had a good weekend. It was fun.
We did.
It was fun. Congratulations to Garrison. Mm-hmm. City Digger, phenomenal
and
job.
And they're re-sanctioned for next year, too.
Yes, they did. We're back
so excited
again.
About that.
We're back again. Mm-hmm. So that's it. That was fun. Guys, keep checking this out. We're going to continue to do more content like this. Make sure you're subscribing to our YouTube channel.
I now
feel like a YouTuber. I'm a YouTuber. I don't know if I am or not, but we'll see. But, hey, Rob, did you like that pork video earlier?
Yeah, I loved it.
Did you like that pork video?
I haven't got to see it yet.
She liked that pork video too. All right, so
good job.
We're gonna continue to do more stuff like that. Just stick around for the So Smug and Gooder show. We have a lot of people. We had a lot of great guests. We got a lot of good barbecuers to come on our show all the time. Y'all make sure y'all subscribe to this thing because we're gonna grow it some more.
Absolutely. All about is having
all right,
fun
guys.
And making fun.
So we'll come back and tell y'all how we did. Maybe Rob did too. So that's it. That's gonna wrap this up for tonight. See ya. All right, Gooder gang. I hope you enjoyed that video, behind the scenes action from a cook-off. That was a lot of fun doing. You even got to see an after show. Not an after show, but an after party from the cook-off. Shout out to the Bryce family for inviting our family out there. It was a great time. We all had a wonderful time. I can tell you, I'm glad I turned the camera off because we all headed to Drunky Town celebrating the cook-off. As for the cook-off, the city of Garrison did a phenomenal job for a first-year event. They were very accommodating and welcoming. Champions Barbecue Alliance, the event rep Laura, she did a phenomenal job as well. Congratulations to Tiny E Barbecue, Tim Esch with Tiny E Barbecue for Grand Champion. Also Anna and Scotty Bryce with East Texas Smokers for Reserve Grand Champion. As for us, Team Bullhorn, we finished with a sixth place bird chicken. I did not turn in, as y'all saw, the big fail of the tiger stripe or jailbird Tiger Stripe Chicken. Did not turn that one in. Sixth place, we hit a fifth place rib. Big second place pork. You guys got to see the boxing and the preparation for that. I'm glad that I was able to do that. It was a lot of work, but hopefully you guys took something from that. And big second place pork. We had a fourth place brisket, and we finished third overall. And I will definitely take that and roll on to the next one. So, guys, I hope you, if you're still watching this, you're my hero. I mean, this was a long video. I may not do them this long next time, maybe break them up. But thanks for watching this video. If you're still here, please subscribe to the channel. If you're going to want to follow us on all social media, we're on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, even the TikTok. We're doing some TikToks as well. If you want to follow Bullhorn, you're able to do that as well. We're on Instagram and Facebook under Bullhorn BBQ. But guys, if you enjoyed this kind of content, my fall schedule is packed. We're going to be doing quite a bit more of these. We got the Royal coming up in four short weeks. I've got some cook-offs lined up all throughout the fall. Even some tailgating. I do some tailgating for the Texans. I don't know how often I'll be out there this season, but when I am, we'll definitely turn the camera on. You can check out some of that. That's always a lot of fun. So, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this, and we will see you at the next one. Later.